logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for people of Indian origin in Canada. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Hindi, Punjabi and Gujarati languages. And our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are... In India, the TDP has quit the Modi government and the UAE has extradited a close aide of Mafia Don, Dawood Ibrahim Kaster. In Punjab, Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has held bilateral meeting with the British High Commissioner. And Minerva Punjab has won its maiden I-League title. In Canada, a former Sikh militant Jaspal Atwal has claimed to have renounced terrorism. And there will be no special treatment for US if it rejoins the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, Canada and Punjab.
Get the mortgage that's best for you from Abdul Kaiser, Principal Broker of Ingenious Mortgages. We offer first and second mortgages and refinancing. We deal with multiple lenders. We also conduct the REMIC course and exam to become a mortgage agent in just 1 week at our location. Call us at 416-887-9196 or log on to www.ingeniousmortgages.ca.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: The TDP has quit the Modi government, with its ministers P. Ashok Gajapati Raju and Y.S. Chaudhary submitting their resignations. The move comes in accordance with the party's decision since the centre was not granting special status to Andhra Pradesh. A designated Tada court has sent absconder Mohammed Farooq Yasin Mansoor to police custody till March 19. He's an accused in the 1993 Mumbai serial blast and a close aide of Mafia Don Dawood Ibrahim Kaskar. He had been extradited from Abu Dhabi. The CBI has approached the Supreme Court against the Allahabad High Court acquittal of Dr. Kapil Rajesh Talwar and Nupur Talwar. The case pertains to the murder of their daughter Arushi and domestic help Hemraj. Rajesh Talwar has been accused of killing his daughter in a fit of rage. The Supreme Court has restored the controversial marriage of Hadia, formerly a Hindu, with Shafin Jahan, setting aside a Kerala High Court order annulling their wedding. Hadia's father had alleged that she was forcibly converted by groups with links to terrorist outfits. Congress President Rahul Gandhi has asserted that there is a general atmosphere of intimidation that exists in India. He attacked Prime Minister Narendra Modi, saying that an extremely nasty form of politics was taking root in the country and that he would defeat him in the next election. Fugitive jeweler Mehul Choksi has said that it was impossible for him to return to India because his passport has been suspended. He's accused of causing fraud worth crores of rupees to the Punjab National Bank. The Enforcement Directorate will attach more properties of former Global Steel Holdings Limited chairman Pramod Kumar Mittal. This is for allegedly defrauding government-owned state trading corporation of 2,112 crore rupees. A container ship is reportedly burning off Agati Island in the Arabian Sea amid fears of a potential ecological disaster. Indian officials revealed that its cargo was of dangerous class. Officials have ruled out the possibility of any environment issues at the moment. Three rescued sailors are critical. India has thrashed Bangladesh by 6 wickets as the men in blue registered their first victory in the T20 International Cricket Tri-Series. After Bangladesh set a modest target of 140, India reached the target swiftly, riding on a half century by Shikhar Dhawan. Actress Jacqueline Fernandez, who hails from Sri Lanka, says that she always wanted to be an entertainer but didn't plan getting into Bollywood. She made her debut in the Indian film industry with the 2009 film Aladdin. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from Punjab and Canada follows.
When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call. When you are buying or selling a house or a business, you need proper guidance. We at JP Mellon Law Firm have the knowledge and the expertise to help you close your transaction hassle-free. For all your real estate needs, give us a call.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has met British High Commissioner Dominic Asquith to discuss cooperation in various fields of industries and development. Both also spoke on methods to check illegal immigration from Punjab into the UK. Minerva Punjab Football Club have lifted their maiden I-League title, defeating Churchill Brothers Football Club 1-0 to win the league. villain Oboku Asaidu scored the decisive goal in the 15th minute, which the team defended till the very end. Minerva became the first team from Punjab to win the title. A high-level delegation of SAD will meet Home Minister Rajnath Singh and Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Mehbooba Mufti to discuss the problems faced by Sikhs in Jammu and Kashmir. President Sukhbir Singh Badal assured that he will take up the issue after meeting a delegation of the Jammu and Kashmir Sikhs. A hunger strike organized by All India Trinamool Congress and other social activists against imposition of GST on langar was forcibly lifted by the Amritsar police. Party State President Manjeet Singh has launched an indefinite stir on Monday. Congress MP from Amritsar Gurjeet Singh Aujla has also joined the protest. Members of Parliament from Punjab felicitated Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan on the International Women's Day. The delegation led by PPCC Chief Sunil Jakhar emphasized on how economic freedom can elevate women's status. Opposition party SAD has accused the Congress government of running away from answering its 1 year of failed promises and misrule. The party criticized the government for deciding to hold a 9-day budget session interlaced with several holidays. An ugly spat broke out between an Aam Aadmi Party legislator and a bureaucrat at the latter's office in Punjab's Faridkot district. The legislator told the media that the officer did not behave properly with him as per protocol for a sitting legislator. Members of the Maharashtra Sikh Association have held protests outside the Navi Mumbai Municipal Corporation demanding justice for those killed in the 1984 anti-Sikh riots. The organization accused the ruling BJP government of not doing enough to bring the killers to justice. Women and Child Development Minister Razia Sultana has announced the extension of Beti Bachao Beti Padhao scheme to 19 districts of the state. She promoted Tarantaran district as the prime example for facilitation by the centre on the third anniversary of the scheme. Romance and drama-packed Punjabi movie Long Lachi starring Neeru Bajwa and Ami Virk will be hitting the screens this weekend. The trailer of the much-awaited movie created buzz among the audience. Amberdeep Singh, along with his stellar acting, has also written and directed the movie. I'll be back. Stay locked on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Canada follows. Scans
Accounting. A team of highly professional accountants, we deliver quality and immeasurable assistance to our clients. For Canada audit assistance and your business loans, the only name you can trust. A professional accountant always makes a difference. For more information, call us at 416-741-0801 or visit us at scansaccountants.com.
Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com, and the top 10 headlines from Canada are: a former Sikh militant Jaspal Atwal, convicted of trying to kill an Indian cabinet minister in 1986, has claimed that he no longer supports Sikh separatism. He also claimed to have renounced terrorism and admitted to have asked to go to India with Trudeau. Atwal's photograph with Trudeau's wife in Mumbai had recently stirred a controversy. There will be no special treatment for US if it rejoins the Trans-Pacific Partnership, Canada has clarified. Donald Trump had pulled out of the deal after being elected as president. Recently, a senior official of the Trump administration had shown interest in rejoining the trade pact. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has applauded his government's efforts and is confident towards securing exemption on hefty tariffs. However, he has stated that he wants to go slow as Canada was dealing with an unpredictable US administration. Leader of Bloc Québécois, Martin Ouellet, wants to conduct a referendum to decide the party's main role. Recently, 10 MPs stormed out of the party over Ouellet's leadership style and focus of Quebec independence. Canada will be delivering $570 million to Northwest Territories for infrastructure development. The funds will be delivered over 10 years. Canada is also signing bilateral agreements with other provinces and territories across the country. Former United States Vice President Al Gore has praised Ontario's cap and trade system, calling it better than carbon tax. Gore is considered as a crusader against climate change. Currently, opposition Conservative Party is fighting to impose carbon tax rather than cap and trade system in the election-prone zone. Civil rights activist Viola Desmond has been featured on new $10 currency bill. Viola's sister Wanda Robson was present at the unveiling ceremony along with Finance Minister Bill Morneau. Viola has been well celebrated for her fight for the rights of black people in Nova Scotia. Dan Ronald, a consultant, has criticized the proposal of Ottawa's health department to ban pot smoking in apartments. He has claimed the ban will drive people to break the law. Ronald was one of the consultants who shaped marijuana policy in Denver, Colorado in 2014. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau will be nominating a woman to head the RCMP. Brenda Liuki is the potential candidate for the new commissioner. She's also assisted in the UN Civilian Police mission in Haiti. She'll be the first woman to lead RCMP. Alberta Premier Rachel Notley has threatened to turn off the taps in a dispute with British Columbia. Notley has claimed to pass legislation to cut oil flow over the Trans Mountain Pipeline expansion issue. The expansion, set to cost $7.4 billion, would triple Alberta's crude transport. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-Canadian businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Welcome to the Field Fresh Supermarket. One-stop shop for fresh vegetables, fruits, bakery products, Indian and Chinese grocery and much more. Visit us today at 5661 Steeles Avenue East in Scarborough, major intersection Steeles and Middlefield. Check out our weekly flyers. Field Fresh Supermarket, always fresh.
Ritesh Sidwani and Farhan Akhtar's banner XL Entertainment produced Dawn in 2006 and Dawn 2 in 2011, starring Shah Rukh Khan in the lead while Priyanka Chopra as his leading lady. However, now, trade analyst Ramesh Bala confirmed that Chopra is no longer the leading lady and will be replaced by a new actress. Bala took to Twitter, "Shah Rukh Khan's Dawn 3 will be shot extensively in Dubai and Abu Dhabi. The movie is expected to go on the floors sometime in 2019. A new actress will play the leading lady role." However, Sidwani had earlier said that they were working on the said movie but didn't give any confirmation on the leading lady opposite Shah Rukh Khan. Earlier, it was also said that Deepika Padukone had replaced Priyanka Chopra. So will Deepika be the new actress? Well, let's wait for a confirmation from the producers.
Immigration Terminal, the specialist for visitor visa, student visa, business immigration, family sponsorship, work permits, PNP programs, live-in caregivers and LMIA applications. Highly experienced in cases involving criminal or medical admissibility and previously refused or misrepresentation cases. Call 416-675-5666 in Ontario or 778-927-3455 in BC. Email us at info@immigrationterminal.ca. Immigration Terminal, right consultants, right future.
Comedian Sunil Grover rose to fame with his character as Guthi in stand-up comedian Kapil Sharma's comedy Come Talk Show. Now he reveals whether or not will he be a part of the latter's new show. During an interaction, Grover bluntly said,
"Haan ji, main us show mein nahi hu. Main us show mein nahi hu. Aur is tarah ka mujhe koi prastav nahi hai."
Stating that he got to fame donning the character of a woman, he said, "It's because of women we are in this world."
Jitna औरतों ने सब कुछ समाज में जो औरतों के बिना तो पॉसिबल ही नहीं है समाज, और मेरा तो बहुत लगाव है उनके साथ, ख़ास करके मैं तो खुद एक औरत बनता हूँ, तो मेरा तो ज़्यादा ग्रैटिट्यूड है उनको, इस जेंडर को मैंने ज़्यादा पॉपुलैरिटी हासिल की है वैसे।
Well, Sunil didn't mention anything about his future projects. He said he will reveal once they are finalized.
Karol Bagh Jewelers, ਗਹਿਣਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਲੇਟੈਸਟ ਡਿਜ਼ਾਈਨ ਲਈ ਪਹਿਲੀ ਚੁਆਇਸ। ਸੋਨੇ ਅਤੇ ਹੀਰੇ ਦੇ ਸੈੱਟ, ਚੂੜੀਆਂ ਅਤੇ ਕੜੇ, ਚੇਨ, ਜੜਾਉ ਸੈੱਟ ਅਤੇ ਹੋਰ ਵੀ ਕਈ ਗਹਿਣਿਆਂ ਤੇ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲ ਡਿਸਕਾਊਂਟ। ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਵੱਡੀ ਚੁਆਇਸ, ਬਿਹਤਰੀਨ ਸਰਵਿਸ ਅਤੇ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਵਾਜਿਬ ਰੇਟਾਂ ਲਈ ਆਓ ਕਰੋਲ ਬਾਗ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ ਅਤੇ ਰੂਪ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ। ਕਰੋਲ ਬਾਗ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ, 1098 ਪੀਟਰ ਰੋਬਰਟਸਨ ਬੁਲੇਵਾਰਡ, ਬ੍ਰੈਂਪਟਨ। ਰੂਪ ਜਵੈਲਰਸ, 503 ਰੇ ਲੋਸਨ ਬੁਲੇਵਾਰਡ, ਬ੍ਰੈਂਪਟਨ।